Hi, this is Carter Conlon. Welcome again today to Devotions from My Kitchen, where I tell you why I'm not afraid. And today I want to talk about a wonderful and somewhat astounding character in the Bible called Samson, a young man who was set apart by God, empowered by the Spirit of God to bring about great deliverance for many, many people of his generation. But he made a terrible mistake. He let the spirit of the age in which he lived to seduce him. And he literally fell asleep on the knees of this seduction that took away his separation unto God. You see, what marked him as a man of God is that he was separated unto God. And the mark of his separation was the hair on his head, had never been shaven. And you and I, as believers in Christ, we're called to be separated unto God. And we have a mark of separation unto God is that our hearts are separated to him and set apart for him, for his kingdom, for his work. And sometimes people make the same mistake that Samson once made. They fall asleep to the seductions of this life and of this world. And suddenly that separation unto God and for the purposes of God is taken away from them. And in the case of Samson, the scripture says, when his hair was shaven, he became weak as any other man. Here's what the scripture says. The Philistines took him and they put out his eyes. In other words, he had no vision anymore to see a way forward. He lost the sight of his own calling. And they brought him down to Gaza, a place where he wasn't really destined to live or be. They bound him with bronze fetters and he became a grinder in the prison. However, the hair of his head began to grow again after it had been shaven. You know, see, what the devil and all of those given to his work didn't understand is the mercy of God and the forgiveness of God. And even if we've made mistakes in our life, and yes, maybe we've embraced things we shouldn't have, and because of it, we've been brought into a place of weakness. We've lost our effectiveness. Could even be in our own homes. We've lost our effectiveness in our communities, our churches. Perhaps those that were called into the ministry, you feel like your ministry has been lost. And so we find ourselves very much in the position that Samson was once in. We feel like we're in a prison house, just grinding day to day, just trying to get through from one day to the other. No great deliverance is being won from our lives. But while all of this was happening, and while the devil was holding a party over this man's head, something began to happen. His hair began to grow. His separation unto God, that which marked him as separated unto God, began to grow again. So here we are, the Church of Jesus Christ in our generation. We're stuck in our homes. Many of us feel like we're just grinding our way through the day. We perhaps in great measure lost our vision of the future. But I want to tell you, something is happening to us. We are being marked again by God. And I just want to serve notice on every devil of hell that is still out there mocking the people of God today. In case you haven't noticed, our hair is starting to grow in this separation. And by God's grace, we are going to be the people that God has called us to be. I don't know about you, but my hair is starting to grow again. God bless you. Love you. See you again tomorrow.